local food is not a new concept. It's just a really, really awesome concept that I think is really important right now with everything that's changing in the world. I think just to know where your food comes from is a really powerful thing.
I used to believe that you needed acres to grow food, but really if you have a small plot of land, you can grow a ton of food. Even if you don't have land and you just grow things in containers, it's possible. And I feel like just when people walk by, they can learn by what we have going on at GCC.
The more people see this garden, the more people ask questions, well, what are you guys doing? What is permaculture? Then the more everyone will learn, and this can become more common knowledge for everyone, because it works really well.
As we're dealing with climate change, food, securing food is going to be much more difficult, and I feel really passionate that we should all learn how to become at least somewhat self-sufficient in growing our own food. And I think that having the permaculture garden here at GCC is a really great showcase. It's a very public place in this community.
We're experimenting and doing things on the college in an educational setting with nature, and that's where we need to get is like that we don't need to just control nature, we need to sit back and let her do her thing and learn from it.
Permaculture is the practice of going out into nature and observing the patterns and processes found in ecosystems. We then notice those beneficial relationships and try mimicking them in the design of systems that meet our needs as people while at the same time working to regenerate the land. This is a permaculture garden because it's mimicking the patterns and processes in nature. We're using organic material to build soil fertility. We're using small-scale earthworks to capture rainwater and use it to passively irrigate crops. We have really diverse perennials here, and that structural diversity mimics the patterns in, say, a forest ecosystem.
The seed idea for this permaculture garden began in fall 2011, which was the first offering of the Introduction to Food Systems class as a pilot year. And the students identified that the knowledge to grow food on small scales, marginal land, backyards, was really lacking in some ways. And if residents in the community had those skills, we could actually really help increase our food security and resilience. And so they said, hey, GCC is an incredible leverage point. It's really accessible, it's really visible. We have lots of different groups moving in and out of the campus. And why not demonstrate how to grow food in marginal spaces with a permaculture garden that's used for educational purposes? After the food systems class, 6 inspired students came asking how they could advocate and design for a garden on campus. We created a special topics course, the Permaculture Student Forum, for them to do so.
Got out of food systems and we came up with the idea to keep it going and really make the idea happen. And our teacher, Abra, had brought up that there was potential garden space.
We started coordinating with Ryan Harb at UMass and some others there, and they basically mentored us a little bit on their process. They also gave a $1,000 micro grant to kind of help get the garden up and started. In addition to the $1,000 micro grant from UMass, Lisa DePiano of Mobile Design Lab donated $1,000 worth of mature plant stock for the permaculture garden. In addition to this really generous donation, we received small plant donations from Food Forest Farm in Holyoke and Time Herbal in Amherst.
So 6 students came out of that and decided to be a part of a student forum to make 3 phases of design for GCC. And the first has been approved and is now in place and is flourishing. So the first is the permaculture garden that is very diverse and offers herb gardens and vegetables and flowers. And then the second phase of the garden is the orchard, third phase that I was a part of with my classmates. And we made a garden design to have edible landscaping, a permanent structure for 4-season display.
And the students were so excited. They put on a huge stakeholder charrette. I had students going on the radio and being interviewed. I had students posting on Facebook, flyering all over, sending out information to listservs, and really getting buy-in both from the larger community and meeting with different departments and offices on campus.
The charrette, that was the first public charrette I'd ever been involved in, and it was really impressive to see community members coming out just to talk about these issues facing the community.
Heard their input on what they'd like to see in their garden, in their community, and had them do a bunch of sketches of how they'd see the landscape playing out. And we took all that information.
And we put those suggestions and goals into our design.
And we worked closely as a group of six and supported each other in creating designs to offer to GCC.
And then we invited those same people back to our final presentations where we showed them exactly what our plan was based on what was here and what they had said they wanted to see in a demo garden.
It was my passion to support them in realizing the goals they had set forth. And that's where I feel really engaged in this project and really invested. If it wasn't for the students, this garden would not be here.
The students just came up with a very grand plan for a three-phase permaculture garden and asked administration through me to get permission to do this. I and Abra made a presentation to the president's staff and here we are.
The idea of the garden was so compelling. It's not just making sure that the garden is here and producing the flower or the berry or that particular vegetable. Really, it's about students getting involved and their learning by using their hands. And so much good learning happens not when people are face to face, but when they're working side to side like they do up here in the garden.
It was a really exciting process to get the okay to get on this site and to start it.
I was the student who did the initial design for the garden itself for phase one, which is right here in front of the greenhouse. You look at what you have, and what we had to work with was a grading map. We weren't allowed to set foot on the property, or this particular eighth of an acre, because it was a construction site. And we had actually finished the design before we could even step foot on the land. So it shifted pretty drastically.
I spent a lot of time on acquiring the plant materials, acquiring the resources, the compost, mulch that we needed to actually build the gardens. It took several soil samples and figured out what we needed to do for building up the soil.
So the design was very off in certain ways, and we couldn't get all the plants we wanted, and our budget was non-existent, so we were really changing as we went.
We learned in permaculture that having to adapt to change and evolve and acknowledge things that aren't working out, it's not failure, it's adapting and it's being resilient and strong.
The days that we were out here making it happen were just the best. I loved being around all different types of people, people I knew, people I didn't know, professors and students, and we really rocked it.
I helped as a consultant with some of the more technical aspects of design, and I also taught a class here last year during the implementation phase. We actually did quite a lot of the layout and the actual work of decompacting the soil following the construction of the greenhouse. We staked out all the beds, we dug some of the initial swales and decompact soils throughout the site, and thought a lot about how stormwater would move down this walkway coming off of the greenhouse and figuring out ways to get it to infiltrate into the soil.
When we tried to put a shovel in the ground, it just didn't budge. It was about 2 inches and then solid earth.
It was so compacted. That was the biggest issue, was trying to break up the soil. And we had students that did that all with hand tools. And so it was a lot of hard work.
We've definitely done a lot of digging and soil remediation and learning about lasagna mulching, where we put down cardboard on top of the earth and then straw to kind of keep the weeds down, but also to build up the soil over time as everything breaks down.
Another unique aspect to a permaculture garden is that it embodies the principles of permaculture, and one of those is using on-site resources, another one is valuing diversity, a third is using biological or living capital. We're actually cycling on-site resources from the campus, from the forest, from the greenhouse propagated here, and we're embodying those principles in the garden and really closing the loop.
Community Planting Day was like the culmination of all this hard work. It was the funnest day of hard work I've ever done, and I've done a lot of hardworking days, and that was something to say for me where I was having a ball.
One of the things that was so exciting about this was that it really was student-driven, student-designed.
There was quite a coherent group of people that became a community, and they were out here several hours a week working in the garden.
It was taking this beyond the classroom, where they were, you know, they worked on some of the design and some of the implementation, but it was taking it beyond just that time during the week that they go to the class and actually spend it with other students who were equally as enthusiastic about this project.
The first significant piece of work, other than the administrative work, other than finding funding, other than doing the kind of stuff that supports the work from the background, was that planting day where, I don't know, dozens of students, the VetNet group, students from all walks of life at the college, staff from all different departments in the college came out to begin the planting of this garden. I have to say that was one of the more exciting days of work I ever had in my life.
And I was nervous. I was nervous it wasn't going to go well, we weren't going to be prepared, no one would show up, it would rain, it would be too hot.
People from all parts of the school came out, you know, folks from VetNet, faculty, students, and once again it was just unbelievably fun, and everybody was smiling and putting plants in the ground. Some people had never gardened before, some people had been working in their grandmother's garden their whole life.
Life-changing to see, especially to see people that I had never met come out and really care about it and be willing to spend hours in the hot sun using a pickaxe to break up the compacted soil so that we could put our rain garden in. And also to see the people that had been working right beside me or giving a bit of guidance for the whole semester and way before that. I had this tribe around me, and every time I do this kind of work, I feel them there. So it's a pretty powerful experience to have had.
It's kind of the human spirit story where you're like, kind of got to step back and go, oh, look at them. They're so happy to be in the dirt right now.
Colleagues have reflected that I've never seen so many students be so continually and actively involved in a project. And the work that you all have been doing here is really changing the face of GCC and changing the level of student participation in the college. Year round, we're able to sustain the garden with summer interns that are receiving college credit. During the academic year, the Permaculture Student Club on campus meets once a week. And then we also have classes that come out and work in the garden periodically during the year.
Being able to bring other classes and other faculty members and their research projects into this site will not only improve the performance and appearance of this site, but also is a great opportunity for students to really delve deep into the professional relationships that exist between different areas of expertise.
I think this greenhouse, this garden, this whole focus on sustainability, which is what the work we're doing around energy systems, the work we're doing around regenerating the land, has much broader implications for all classes, for art classes, for writing classes, for social science classes. It really is about life and both academic and life and college life as a whole. And so I expect that this broad project, the project around sustainability, will reverberate for many years to come.
It's a statement about the college's values, it's a statement about the farm-to-food program, it's a statement about the community that we serve. Just as it is important for the non-artist to go past the art gallery and to experience art, it's good for the nurse, it's good for the police officer, it's good for the philosopher and the physician to walk past a permaculture garden.
A lot of folks come here for work, they walk past the garden and see the aesthetic value of the beauty of the garden. I've appreciated that more than anything, I guess, being here and being a part of that and getting some of that positive feedback from the community at large.
I don't think I've done a project anything like this, where I got to see it go from paper to reality.
What came out of it is actual change, and the power that I see in the students now who've been involved throughout this process to envision something, to articulate what they're envisioning, to advocate for that change, and then to see it through into implementation is an incredibly powerful message to send students and for those students to go out and tell their peers and for that to ripple out through the community.
That's the biggest thing I've learned, I guess, like, not in terms of like technical knowledge, but in terms of like how amazing this is and like how much of an impact it can have on someone and how much I want to do it in that fashion for the rest of my life.
In the networking, I've been able to form relationships with my professors and my classmates, and the coming together to make this happen is just phenomenal. I think it's also been really important to me personally in terms of being part of a community like this, and that we all, you know, we all get together and talk about our weeks and work together, and it's really, in sort of the craziness of life, it's really a calm oasis.
When we have friends visit from the city, we bring them to the garden, they work in the garden with us, and it's always a positive experience. It's always really fun.
It's not a privately owned thing. It's a space that anybody from anywhere can walk up to, and eventually, hopefully we'll have the signs up so they can walk up to some plants they don't know and read a sign and know that they can eat it, or that they can come back for a cutting and take it home and start something for their community, wherever that is.
We were part of a great idea that was really worth it and worth putting that energy into the change.
I always hear people say that they don't have a green thumb and that they just can't do it, but you can.